Hi, my name is Charlie Brown Oshea. I am also known as the Tattooed Millionaire. I will be on the online prosperity show talking about my journey in becoming a multiple business owner. Stay tuned in.
Welcome to yet another exciting episode of the Online Prosperity Show. And today I've brought you the Tattooed Millionaire himself, Charlie Oshea. Charlie, how are you doing, my man?
I'm wonderful, Prosper. How are you going, mate?
Absolutely. Thank you so much for making the time on the show today. Now, obviously, if you're watching this show right now, you would understand that we're always bringing about people that are on their journey doing great things out and about there, or they're actually running businesses that are profitable and enjoyable. Now, I've been friends with Charlie for quite a while. We've been, communicating here and there. He's very supportive. He's also a family man. We are in a couple of groups that represent that aspect. And a lot of people seem to not be able to juggle and put all of those things together. And Charlie is a man for you there. He's also world-renowned, tattooed millionaire. We're going to be talking about those pieces of, that part of his life and the pieces that he has on him and what they actually represent and how they've helped him along the journey. Now, some people might have different perspective as to how your appearance or the way you should be, is the way that a business should be run. But I think Charlie would like to think otherwise. Now, thank you so much for your time there, Charlie. And, obviously you're going to drop in a lot of value on this show. Now, tell us a little bit about your story and how you actually became famously known as the Tattooed Millionaire.
Oh, well. My journey as a businessman, well, a legitimate businessman, probably started 5 years ago. My entrepreneurial side probably started when I was about 7 or 8. Let me see. Me and my wife, we own coin laundries throughout Melbourne. We started our first probably, just going on to 5 years now. We're just about to build our third in Melbourne, and we're building our first in Bali, hopefully by June or July. And we're also looking at other avenues in business as well.
Absolutely. That's pretty amazing there. So you did say, when you were 7 or 8, that's where your entrepreneurial journey started off. What is it that you did at that time?
I think I was in probably grade 3, grade 4. I actually ended up stealing the school logo ID tag, and I had it photocopied at the local library. I had about 5 or 6 of them photocopied, because in those days, the only place you could get a photocopy was a library. So I did that. Then I went and got these jars of marbles, and I bought 3 or 4 books of raffle tickets. And I got a whole lot of mates together. And what I did was I got them to go door to door and told them the school was doing a raffle, and it was 40 cents a ticket. At the end of the day, they'd all come back to me and they would make 20 cents per ticket that they sold, and I would keep the rest.
Wow.
No one ever won a raffle. This is before the days of actually understanding what integrity meant.
Absolutely, absolutely. Obviously, even having an idea like that at that sort of age, would constitute you being having a creative, entrepreneurial mind later on. So the kind of work that you're involved in right now, the coin laundries, can you just explain for those people that are not aware of what actually happens there, what it is?
Yeah. A coin laundry is a self-service laundry that you go to. All our coin laundries are 24 hours. You go there, you wash your clothes, you dry your clothes, watch a bit of TV. Then you go home. And because we are 24 hours, it's just so convenient for people. Because when we first opened our first laundry, going on 5 years now, me and the wife were sitting there trying to discuss, should we open at 6? Should we close at 7? Should we open at 5, close at 10? And at that time, I was actually reading one of Warren Buffett's books. And he actually had this verse that actually stated, if you cannot make money while you're sleeping, you will never truly be wealthy. Well, that's when the penny dropped, and it was 24 hours.
Absolutely. And you haven't stopped at there. You did mention you now have 3 of these centres in and around Australia?
We've got three in Melbourne, and we're looking at our fourth, and we're looking at our first international by probably June, July, August in Bali.
Absolutely. Would that be the same sort of market when you go overseas, or is that something that you'd have?
Well, it's marketed towards the tourist.
Right.
It's all tap and go. You go in there, because if anyone that's ever been to Bali, understand even in the summer season, it's always humid. And to get things washed and dried over there can be impossible. So this is more for the actual tourist and the backpackers and so forth, where they can just go in, do a lot of washing, do a lot of drying, and then get back to their holiday, rather than waiting 3 days for a local to wash it, hang it out, and hopefully get it all dried.
Absolutely. So obviously in your line of work, you have to do a lot of negotiations, especially maybe with the building owner, for you to have all established.
Oh, for sure. Well, with every business that I've actually built, I have built every business with other people's money. I have never put a cent of my own money into it. Everything I've learned through books. So if I need to learn something that I need to learn, I go and get every book I can on the topic, and I'll just sit down for 3-4 days and just read. So I learned from an early stage in my entrepreneurial walk that you need to use other people's money to become truly wealthy. So what we do is we go into a property, we get the property, we set it up, we make sure there's no repayments until the shop's opened. So technically I'm using everybody else's expertise. I'm using money from credit cards, I'm using money from my equities, banks, whoever would lend me the money. And the first business was quite hard because I had no credit rating. But where there's a will, there's a way. That's what makes us entrepreneurs. Absolutely. So, there's always money there. You just got to be able to know where to find it. And so I open a business, and then my repayments all start, and that's when the customers come in and they pay the business.
Great stuff. So that gives you a high skill or a high level of negotiation there. You did mention that a fair few of the things that you have learnt is from books. Would you have a couple of books that you can recommend to somebody who wants?
I probably read a book every week to 2 weeks. So I've read a lot of books. But Think and Grow Rich. That's the hard copy. That's my Bible. This thing's been marked out. It's been highlighted. I've probably read this book at least 15 times. I have the audio in my car, and I've listened to that over 150 times. I listen to it at least once a month with all my other audios I have. So that's the book that I would recommend anybody to dive into, digest, rip it apart, market. Like I said, this is probably my fourth copy because I got sick of paperbacks. This is a hard copy, and now I'm actually on the verge of trying to find a leather bound. So just the whole concept of something that was written in 1937. And I don't know if you actually know, Prosper, but the movie's been released next, I think it's at the end of this year.
All right.
I saw the trailer for it 2 nights ago.
That should be something we can actually go as entrepreneurs, hold hands and go and watch.
Well, in the last 5 years with the whole entrepreneur boom, where everybody wants to be one, I guess Hollywood saw a market for it.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah. Personally, I don't like calling myself an entrepreneur because unfortunately in my eyes in the last 3 to 5 years, The actual word entrepreneur has been tarnished in my eyes. Now it's become a word that relates to people that are unemployed and sit on Facebook all day. So it's a bit of a slap in the face when everyone calls themselves an entrepreneur, but have nothing to prove it.
Absolutely.
So I prefer to be called a multiple business owner. Because that states that I've got multiple businesses. I don't like to be looked upon from somebody that doesn't know me as an entrepreneur just sits on Facebook and likes things all day.
Great stuff. So obviously, you being a multiple business owner, you are serving and solving a problem that you have established. You know, people need access to washing their clothes 24 hours. I also intercepted somewhere where we had a chat, and you did mention you are also going to be solving yet another problem that comes around, you know, the looking after of kids. Can you just walk us through that one there too?
Yeah, well, we're getting our childcare license because I want to be the first person to ever open a 24-hour childcare in this country, because we are living in a 24-hour society these days. So once again, there's another need. And the thing I love about finding people's needs is I've realized the more needs I find, the more businesses I build, the less I physically have to work. And that's the bonus. Because when we actually originally looked at getting into business, my wife and her ex-partner, they had a fish and chip shop many, many years ago. And her whole concept of business was working 15 to 16 hours a day, 7 days a week in a fish and chip shop, and only having 2 or 3 weeks off in January. So when I came up with this whole, let's get into business, she was just, nah, not interested. I would rather stay at work and have my weekends. And then I actually looked at her and I said, look, if I have to get into a business that I have to work more than 5 hours a week in, I'm not interested. And then she looked at me with another stupid look. What sort of business are you looking into? I said, well, I don't know at the moment. That's the whole thing. Let's find something that's needed. Absolutely. And that's the thing. There are laundries around Melbourne, but a lot of them are 30, 40 years old. The owners don't care about the customers. As long as they're getting a bit of money coming in, you know, they're dirty, they're old, there's no entertainment. So all we did, we didn't reinvent anything. We just took a product and made it better. And that's all it comes down to.
Absolutely. So obviously the future is dotted with, you know, you solving problems and being there for the family, since you're not going to be working as hard.
Well, that's it. The goal is to start our businesses in Bali as well, because we've got a very good friend over there that's like a brother to me. And because of the actual Balinese laws, he has to be a 50% partner, which is, I actually think it's really good for any country, because that means half the profits would actually stay in that country. But then again, we've decided that all the profits are staying there because I'm not going to pay a double tax. I don't see why the Australian ATO should get any money out of my money there when it's got nothing to do with them.
Absolutely.
So, yeah, if you can save money in tax, it's just as good as making it.
Absolutely. So, you know, people might be interested in knowing and finding out how they can learn more from you. Is there a way that people can get a hold of you that, you know, you can teach?
Yeah, well, at the moment I'm on Facebook. I really haven't set up any pages yet, because I'm actually in multiple pages, and it can be fun trying to keep up with everybody's lives. And that's the thing. I have the time to do this. I really don't know how people that actually work jobs find the time to do this, unless they work in an office and they can watch it while they're working. Because to keep up with everybody, it can be really daunting. And as long as I'm encouraging people, that's my whole purpose, is to encourage people to move on. Like yesterday, I met a young man from LA. He actually met me through one of the sites, and I think we just text each other for about 2-3 hours. He's asked a question, I've answered the question, and he was quite surprised, because he's actually spoken to other so-called entrepreneurs, and within, say, half an hour of talking to someone, all of a sudden they'll jump on him and, you know, there's, you know, I can do this, but it's going to be a fee now, blah, blah, blah. And I find that there's so many people that are on the internet these days that have nothing to show where they come from, and they don't have anything to show, that are actually up there saying we are this, we are that, when really they're not. And this young man said, I can't believe that you've just spent all this time with me and you haven't even asked me for a dollar. I said, well, this is my gift that I'm giving back, because I make enough money from what I do. Now it's my turn to bless other people. And if I had said one thing in the last half an hour that has made you step over your threshold, to step through your fear, I'm giving back to the universe. I believe in giving with an open heart and receiving with open arms. And believe me, my arms can be really wide.
Absolutely. Great stuff. Well, obviously, if you would, indulge us there, Charlie, you'd notice that we sort of at the beginning of the year right now, and a lot of people would still be going through their New Year's resolutions, and they're still really trying to figure out.
Most people are giving up on them already.
Who they're going to become, or some people have already forgotten them already. Now, what sort of advice can you leave to those budding, business people that also want to start and establish international businesses like you have done for yourself? And even if they're coming in from a position of they can't do anything with what they have right now.
The first thing I would actually say to anybody is self-education. I had a gentleman once ask me to talk to him about another business idea he had. And I actually just said to him, because I just wanted to test the waters with him. And I said, okay, yeah, it sounds promising. And yeah, it might be something I can look at doing with you. But you got to do something for me first. Okay. I said, there's a book called Rich Dad, Poor Dad. Very easy read. You can probably knock it off in a week, 2 weeks if you're taking your time. Read that book, come back to me and tell me what you think. He's looked at me and he goes, I haven't read a book since high school, because I'm not reading no bloody book. And I said, really? I said, look, if you're not going to take the time to educate yourself, I'm not wasting my fucking time actually trying to teach you. If you're not willing to put in the 90%, don't expect me to help you with the 10. It's that simple. And he didn't do it. He went ahead with his business idea and he lost $85,000.
Absolutely.
And he really hates seeing me now because I bring it up every time.
Great stuff. So you do recommend a lot of self-education.
That's the first step. The second step is goals. Yeah, this year alone, I've got 20 goals. I write my goals every day. Okay. There's a statistic that actually, what interview was it? I think it was Grant Cardone. He actually states that he has surveyed and he reckons that the only difference between a millionaire and a billionaire is, when he's asked people, is millionaires usually write their goals daily. Billionaires do it twice a day. That's saying something.
All right.
You've got to put your goals down. Like, I write my goals now, and, the first couple of weeks I was like, oh, shit, what was number 3? And, number 6 was Now I can put my 20 goals down without even looking at the other page, because it's going into my subconscious. It's there. It's been trained. It's the same as when you learn to drive a car. The first 3 to 4 weeks of driving a car, you hop in, seatbelt, hang on, ignition, park. And everyone does it. They touch both pedals, brake, accelerator. After a month, you jump in a car and you don't even think about it. Because once your subconscious is programmed, this conscious mind then hands the job over to the subconscious mind. This is one thing that people don't understand with the conscious and subconscious mind, is the conscious mind is always 3 steps behind the subconscious. So whatever is programmed in your subconscious is what your conscious will always gravitate to. And yeah, people say it's rubbish, but it's in fact that if you open up a newspaper in front of you, your subconscious has taken in every word, every picture on that double page. While it's doing that, it's also listening to the birds in the background. It's just seen the traffic lights change over here. It's listening to everyone else's conversations. Even though you're not focused on it, your subconscious has just taken it all in within seconds.
And making your heart beat at the same time.
Beat and pumping your blood, making you breathe. And then your conscious mind goes, oh, that looks interesting. And you might even think to yourself after you spot, you think, how the hell did I spot that little article on this big newspaper? Because your subconscious is already taking it all in. Your conscious mind's three steps behind. So your conscious mind's already seen that. Okay, this is what he likes. But we take for granted the subconscious mind. Everyone thinks that they've got control of their life. That's not control, that's your ego. That's why your ego has no control over your bodily functions. Because if your ego was allowed to actually try to make you breathe, you'd be dead within seconds. Because there's no way you can focus on breathing, walking, pumping your heart all at the same time. But the thing is, people focus on this conscious mind. And no one ever talks about the subconscious. And that's what I love about this book, Thinking Grow Rich. It just opens you to so many avenues and views.
Absolutely. If there's anything that I got from this interview today is that most of these things are self-made, all right? And judging from your tattoos in your hands there, you have to actually be self-made. And I think it was Les Brown that mentioned that a few people, you know, everyone is self-made, but only the successful people, you know, acknowledge it. So it has been a pleasure talking to you, my man.
Oh, no, it's always been a pleasure talking to you, regardless.
Absolutely, absolutely. So, I mean, obviously, there's quite a lot that we could discuss, but I think for this show right now, you've brought in the value. People really need to be self-educated. People really need to figure out where they're going, and also really, really make sure their goals are written down. And it's
for sure. And before you go, I'm going to actually show you another thing that I do daily. They say it takes about 21 days to 30 days to actually reprogram your subconscious.
Absolutely.
Okay. So what I do is at the end of every month, I sit down and I work out what I want to actually refocus on. And at the moment, this is one, I do it every day. It's like writing lines at school. Okay. At the moment, I'm doing gates wide open, blessings and wealth flow freely.
So that's your affirmation.
That's my affirmations every day. And it's not just once. People think an affirmation is something they say once in the morning and that's it. That's the problem with a lot of this law of attraction. People have only taken out bits and pieces that they want. For example, if you believe it, you can achieve it. So they sit on their couch watching Neighbours thinking they want $1 million. It doesn't work that way. And the problem is at the end of Neighbours, they don't have the $1 million. They ring up their girlfriend and they go, this shit doesn't work. I've sat here for 45 minutes and the $1 million ain't here. It doesn't work that way. It's something that you have to work towards. You know, and there's another one I've got in here about money flowing freely. You can't hold on to money. Money's like water. It has to flow in and out of your life. You dam it up, you build that dam and you save it all. It's just going to wither because anybody that's got any logic in currency knows there's no value in it. Yeah, I use my debt to make my wealth.
Absolutely.
Well, that's what it comes to. You can't use your money to make your wealth because you'll never become wealthy that way. Absolutely. I use other people's money that becomes my debt, which other people pay. And the money that their actual businesses make, then I invest into real estate. I invest into the stock market. And then that starts generating.
Great stuff. A lot of people are going to be wanting to learn all of those tricks and tips from you there. And I'm going to be putting your details right at the bottom of this show so that they can also learn from you. So if you were watching, you would actually understand that if you value any success in your life, you really got to go out there and make sure you're self-educating and you're writing out your goals frequently in order for them to be embedded in your subconscious. And as what Charlie has mentioned, your subconscious carries all the instructions that you need in order to be, do, and have either a successful business or a happier existence.
Actually, before you go, Prosper, I'm going to actually, when we get off this call, send you the details. I'm actually yourself. My first book was actually published about 8 months ago. I'm a co-author on a best-selling book called Journey of Riches. I'll send you the details. And that just gives you a chapter of where my life has come from, where I've been, because my life before who I am was quite interesting. I left home at 10. I lived on the streets. I ended up being a drug dealer, a standover man. So I was always in the entrepreneurial side. It's just, it was on that side.
Absolutely.
So okay. It was after prison that I realized that the real criminals, Parliament and everyone else, makes money on this side. As long as you're paying your taxes, it doesn't matter what you're doing, as long as you're paying the taxes, you're okay.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much. I can't wait to see that side of the book and also mention it to our valued guests. All right.
Thank you for your time.
Not a problem, my man. Not a problem.
Take care, my friend.
Good stuff. All right.